the introduction of the Securities Industries Act 211 that brought a lot of changes. And the act was designed with a great degree of flexibility. So what that really means is that we have a lot of guidelines and rules that we are now in the process of implementing. So that entails a consultation process that goes on for several weeks at a time, and that will take us into 2014 as well. Financial services in the Bahamas has been, I guess, somewhat in sync or in pace with what's been happening in the global economy. So particularly at the commission, where we regulate several sectors, in terms of the, not only do we regulate the securities industry, but we also regulate the fund services industry. So what we've seen, particularly in the area of the fund services, is that we've lost some value in terms of assets under management, but that pretty much kept pace with what was happening in the global economy. The main competitive advantage in terms of financial services is the people. We have a vibrant workforce with a cadre of professionals, from lawyers to accountants to very strong operational persons. And that bodes well for us in terms of being positioned to take advantage of new business, new opportunities. That coupled with the fact that we're a small country, and so there's close proximity to a number of key stakeholders like policymakers. So sometimes getting something done is just a telephone call away, as opposed to something that has to go through a large, extensive bureaucratic process. FATCA is quite interesting. There's been a lot of chatter about it recently. For us, from my perspective, I think it's going to have somewhat of an administrative burden, but that's yet to be determined, depending on which model the policymakers decide to go with. So it's an issue of administration, doing all the reporting, making sure the systems and processes are in place to make that happen. So that's really what I see as the most significant impact. The flexibility of the new Securities Industry Act, in terms of allowing the commission to respond very quickly to changes in the environment, whether there's product, services, or international demands, because how that particular act is designed, the commission itself will make rules, as opposed to having to go to the parliament, where you want to amend the act, then that goes to the parliament. We have the ability to make rules and issue guidelines to respond to the needs of the industry, and also ensure that it's properly regulated as it evolves. In addition, I think in being in the process and just coming out of a financial services assessment program, or FSAP, certainly we have a keen understanding of where the changes are needed. So we're doing new things like revamping the Investment Funds Act to make sure it's more prudential as opposed to being disclosure-based. And that, again, bodes well in terms of the Bahamas keeping pace with international standards and best practices. The Bahamas is open for business. We have a well-established regulatory landscape. Certainly, if you put us side to side with any other international financial center, we're pretty much toe-to-toe. I think, most importantly, in December of last year, we achieved the status of signatory A to IOSCO, and IOSCO being the international standard-setting body for securities commissions. So that, I think, says a lot in terms of the regulatory landscape. So regulatory landscape certainly says it's a safe place to do business. I think the agility of the regulator with the enacted legislation says that we have the ability to be responsive as a regulator. And then we have, we're an independent sovereign nation with a common law structure, and the court systems are quite helpful in terms of when there are issues, they go through the court as they would in any established jurisdiction, whether it's the UK, Hong Kong, or even Singapore.